Got a red, red heart.
I would like to think so. We probably all do.
Yeah, I know. Well, I think that's what we were saying before about country and Western, because we don't have a West like in the States where that was invented.
Right.
We've got a red heart. Central Australia is really where our heart is, in a sense.
Right.
Even though we're so diverse in that we live in all the capital cities, the country is really the essential image. The image of the Australian is like the guy with the swagman, you know, the country grazier, you know.
Yes, the desert, the rock, and Alice Springs, where we were recently, and it's very inspiring to be there.
Mm.
I suppose, you know, we all do identify with that. It's the centre of our nation, and metaphorically too, as you put it. So that was the idea of the song, I suppose. The red heart is physically there, but it's also within us, I suppose.
Mm. And that's your new song.
We're
the first ones to hear it on.
You are the first.
In the media.
Yes, you are, and we've just finished recording that. In fact, it's not even quite finished. You're getting an advanced version. And
it's a rough version, mate.
Well, and that's not the final mix there.
No.
But we're hoping that that'll be released soon and widely distributed. And we're hoping for some good reaction to that song.
Mm. Well, I'm really glad that I invited you to come on the Shtick, because you, to me, epitomise the Australian heart. You know, the parodies you do on the Kudabeens inspire me enormously. I love the songs and the way the cleverness of the lyrics put against the songs that we all know. You know, we know the tune, and yet you set a different mode through your lyrics. And the other thing I love, which I just realised, and I don't know if anybody knows out there, you are Guru Bob.
Oh, that's just an allegation.
It's an allegation.
I've just met him a couple of times at the temple. And I've learned to imitate his voice through a lot of exposure.
Give
to
me a
him.
Guru Bobism.
Well, Guru Bob says, the favourite one is to try and imitate him.
Mm-hmm.
Guru Bob says, remember, old saying, when Collingwood loses another grand final, a billion people in China don't care. Think about that.
So that's what Australia is, really, is a sports. We're fanatics. It is like a religion. like Morris said, you know, football is a religion in Australia, and your show is the temple. People go on a Saturday morning on the ABC, the could have beens, and you've actually been exposed now as the Greg champion that we know.
Well, as I say, I've just met Guru Bob in my travels.
Champion, it's been really fantastic to have you. Yeah, how about that? You've come on the shtick, and it's been a real pleasure to have you on board. We're actually going out now with the true iconic number. It's not really a song because there's no music to it, but how much can a koala bear? I don't know. AustenTayshus brought out this song 30 years ago this week. It's being released on iTunes, and the title of it is Australiana. And we're just going to show you the original high definition version. Bob. Guru Bob.
You call me Greg, I think.
I love you, Guru Bob. Thanks very much for being on the shtick.
Thank you
for
saying
this. Cheers.
The story you're about to witness is true. It actually happened. Only the names have been changed to make it funny.
Sitting at home last Sunday morning, me mate Boomerang said he was having a few people round for a barbie. Said he might cook a burra or two. I said, sounds great, will Wallaby there? He said, yeah, and Veggie might come too. So I said to the wife, you want to go, Anna? She said, I'll go if dingoes. So I said to Boomer, what will we do about Nulla? He said, Nulla bores me to tears, leave him at home. We got to the party at about two, walked straight out the kitchen to put some booze in the fridge, and you wouldn't believe it, there's Boomer's wife, Wara, sitting there trying to plait a puss. Now, I don't like to speak ill of Wara, but I was shocked. I mean, how much can a koala bear? So I grabbed a beer, flashed me wanger at her, and headed out to join the party. Pretty soon, airs rocks in, and things really started jumping. This Indian girl, Masu, turns up, dying to go to the toilet, but she couldn't find it. I said to me mate, Al, hey, where can Masu pee, Al? He said, she can go out back with a fella, she's probably seen a cockatoo. Well, just then, Wara comes out of the kitchen with a few drinks for everybody. Fair dinkum, you've never seen a cooler bar, mate. I grabbed a beer and said, thanks, Wara, ta. A couple of Queensland at the party, one smelling pretty strongly of aftershave. He sat down next to me, I turned to him, I said, you know, mate, you reek of stockade. It was a really hot day. Oscar felt like a swim. He said to Ina, you want to have a dip in the river, Ina? She said, I haven't got my cozzy, Oscar. Well, Bo says, come in stark as what a lake air. Ina says, what, without so much as a thread, Bo? Ah, perish a thought. Has Hewcombe been in yet? Well, a few of the blokes decided to play some cricket. Boomer said, why doesn't Wombat? Yeah, and let tenor field. And he said, I should have a bowl, but I was too out of it to play cricket, so I suggested a game of cards. I said, Eliptus, you want a game of eucalyptus? He said, there's no point, mate. Dar wins every time. Well, Bill said he'd like a smoke. Nobody knew where the dope was stashed. I said, I think Marino's. But I was just spinning a bit of a yarn. Barry pulls a joint out of his pocket. Bill says, great, Barry, a reefer. What is it, mate? Oh, noose of heads, of course. He made Adelaide him on me. And it was a great joint, too. Blue Mountains away and his three sisters. Well, I thought I'd roll one myself. I said, chuck us the tally-ho, Bart. He said, they're out on the lawn. Seston, can you get them for us? Bernie said, it's okay, mate. She's appled. I'll get them for you. Just then, Alice springs into action. Starts to pack Bella Bong. But you wouldn't believe it, the bong's broken. I said, Lord, how? Hey, man. Somebody said, well, a didgeridoo. I said, maybe it'll have to. I look in the corner and there's Bass sitting there, not getting into it, not getting out of it. I said, what, is Bass straight or something? Boomer said, as a matter of fact, mate, he's a cop. I said, you're joking, mate, a cop? I'm getting out of here, let's go, Anna. She said, no way, I'm hanging around all gum leaves. Besides, I don't want to leave Jack around a party on his own. Have you seen him? I think he's trying to crack on Toowoomba. He's already tried a Mount Isa. And he'll definitely try to lead you, Australiana. Thank you and good night.